Good afternoon. Today I am presenting the results of my research on effect of sulfates on hydration and properties of belite paste and cement produced from oil shale. Usually sulfates are added to a clinker at the last stage of cement production during the grinding process in the form of gypsum to control setting time and speed of the initial hydration reaction of cement. Prolonged cement workability is ensured by the presence of sulfates, which prevent the instant reaction between aluminates and water and delay the initial setting time beyond 1 hour. The optimal content of gypsum depends on the type, fineness, and mineral composition of cement and may vary within certain limits. The insufficient gypsum content cases an extremely rapid setting called flash set, while the excessive addition of sulfates in cement may lead to internal cracking due to the extended ettringite formation. Since the middle of the last century, scientists have taken a great interest in studying the influence of gypsum, not only on setting time, but also on mechanical properties of cement pastes and hydrated products. In the course of previous studies, it was found that gypsum affects strength and dimensional stability of the cement paste. The previous studies demonstrated that increasing the dosage of sulfates initially increases the strength to the maximum, and then the strength decreases with the further increase of sulfate content in cement composition. The previous studies have confirmed that sulfates also affect the mechanical properties of hardened cement paste, namely compressive strength. The mineral composition of cements has been changing recently due to the use of raw materials and fuels containing high values of impurities. Belite became the basic mineral of many alternative green binders. Thus, the effect of sulfates on belite hydration is of great interest. In this work, the influence of gypsum content on belite cement was studied. The main raw material for which was oil shale. In the course of this study, an increase in hydration rate and strength was found with the optimum gypsum content, which is reached when the sulfates are consumed on the CSA shale and not on the ettringite formation. Experimental program contained four main parts. First of all, clinker preparation with high belite content. The second one is cement preparation with variable sulfate content, which vary from 1.5 to 5% sulfates by mass of cement. Sample preparation, which are cement paste and mortars with water cement ratio 0.5, and testing hydration products by using X-ray diffraction, hydration rate by using colorimetry, and mechanical properties by using standard compressive strength test. Materials which were used in this research were oil shale, limestone, and sand for clinker production, and gypsum humidrate for cement preparation. So oil shale 76%, limestone 18%, and sand 6% was mixed together. Pellets were formed with water and dried in oven at temperature 105, and after that, burned at high temperature at 1250. And after that, a clinker was grind in disc mill and analyzed by XRD. Results of this analysis you can see here. So the main phase in mineral composition of this clinker was belite, about 16%. The next one is allite, about 25%. So after analyzing, this clinker was integrated with gypsum humidrate, amount of which was calculated according amounts of sulfate, which needed, which varies from 1.5 to 5% sulfate by mass of cement. And then we have eight cements with different content of sulfates. After that, we need to prepare our samples for further testing. So we prepared pastes for testing total heat of hydration by using isothermal calorimetry. And also we prepared paste for testing mineral composition by panalytical Empyrean X-ray diffraction. We prepared them in a small vial, 15 milliliters, and after 24 hours, it was demolded and cured in saturated lime solution during 24 hours. And also we prepared mortars for each cement. Mortars we prepared according European norm standard 196 with standard sand and water. And we use for this purpose 25 millimeter cube molds. After 24 hours, we demolded them and cured in a saturated lime solution. And after 48 hours, compressive strength was tested. So here are our first results. The total heat of hydration at 24 hours and 48 hours as a function of sulfate content is presented in this slide. As seen from the graph, heat of hydration after 48 hours increases monotonically with increase of sulfate content. However, this trend is different for the total heat at 24 hours, which demonstrates the maximum around 3.5 of sulfate content. Apparently, maximum heat indicates the optimal value of gypsum in cement, especially considering that Belite has a low heat of hydration. The difference in data between 24 and 48 hours can be explained by aluminate depletion after 1 day. In this slide, you can see the result of compressive strength test. The compressive strengths demonstrate a trend of increase with the increase of sulfate content. The increase strength is steep between 1.5 to 3, but between 3.0 and 5, the increase becomes only moderate. The small size of cubes could be a reason for high standard deviation of some samples. You can see it here. So mineral composition of hydrated cements is presented in figure, in this figure. The graph shows the dependence content of ettringite, belite, and amorphous phase, which is CSHJ, on the sulfate content in cement. The dependence of these phases can be conditionally divided in the three stages. The first stage from 1.5 to 2, the second one from 2 to 3.5, and the third one is after 3.5. At the first stage, the content of ettringite grows, while the amorphous phase remains unchanged. And belite content is decreases, which may indicate that the above stage, all sulfates are consumed in the formation of ettringite. At the second stage, it's most interesting stage for us. The CSH gel grows as fast as the content of belite decreases. This is CSH gel, this is belite content. And ettringite content is constant. This fact may indicate that sulfates at this stage is not spent on the formation of ettringite. Most likely, sulfate is involved in the formation of the gel. At the third stage, after 3.5, amount of amorphous phase and belite is are constant, and amount of ettringite slightly increase, which may indicate the consumption of sulfates on the ettringite formation. So in this slide, you can see two graphs. The left graph shows dependence of hydration degree of belite on the amount of sulfates. The hydration degree of belite can be easily calculated knowing the amount of belite in cement before hydration and the amount of belite in hydrated paste for each sulfate content. It can be seen from graph when 2 points, 4 and 5% of sulfate are removed, this dependence can be called directly proportional. I mean, an increased sulfate content in cement, the degree of hydration of bilite increases almost linearly. A similar trend can be seen in this graph, which is present dependence of strength on hydration degree of bilite. From this graph can be clearly understood that with increasing degree of hydration, strength also increases. During this research, we arrived to these conclusions. At low values of gypsum in cement, sulfates are mainly consumed for the formation of ettringite, but there are also optimal values of gypsum in cement at which sulfates are involved in the formation of CSA chain. Sulfates promote the hydration of bilite cement. The optimal value of gypsum in bilite cement accelerates the hydration reaction and increases the strength of hardened cement. Further studies are needed to better understand the mechanism of the effect of sulfates on the bilite phase of cement. Thank you for your attention. This research was performed in the laboratory of alternative binders under supervision of Professor Simon Jutovsky at the Technion Israel Institute of Technology.